Hi friends, this is NJ, host on this channel. So we will continue our discussion on the Rohini Nakshatra. In this part, we will try to understand the defining traits about this Nakshatra. You know, because our ancient sages, seeds, they did not look at these Nakshatra, these cluster of stars, only as a physical body. They looked at them as the physical bodies with the real life. And someone who is alive, someone who has a life, that should be defined by a proper gender, by a proper caste. So all of that we are going to have our discussion today on this Nakshatra. So before we start our discussion, just a quick recap of all what we have studied in the previous video. We have already discussed that Rohini Nakshatra falls completely in the Taurus zodiac sign. It carries the space from 10 degree to 23 degree 20 minutes within the Taurus zodiac sign. This Nakshatra is being ruled by the planet Moon. When it comes to the Shakti, this Nakshatra holds the Rohana Shakti, which means the power to grow. It is a star of ascent, which has the capacity and the potential to give prominence and influence in the society. When it comes to the deity symbol and the functioning, so the deity, the gods associated with this Nakshatra is the Lord Brahma, one of the trine god who is responsible for the creation in this whole universe. The symbol attached to this Nakshatra is, first is a chariot. This Nakshatra also has an ox cart being pulled by two oxen as its symbol, along with many southern Indian astrologers take the banyan tree and the temple as the symbol attached to this Nakshatra. When it comes to the functioning and the behavior of this Nakshatra, we have already discussed that because of the rulership of the two planets, the feminine planets, Venus, which is ruling the Taurus zodiac sign, and the Moon, which rules this Nakshatra. So it infuses lots of artistic and creative abilities in someone's nature. The person is very fond of beautiful things. Person remains very lucky in the form of getting recognition, becoming a limelight and, getting to the center of attention of everyone. And the flip side of this Nakshatra is that many times people tend to act snobbish. They remain very critical of all those people who are not at par with their expectation. Apart from that, they are very spiritual, they are very religious, and they, just because of too much of the productivity involved in this Nakshatra, these people also want to remain to be of good use of the family, of the society, of the country in general which they belong to. So now we will try to understand the defining traits of this Nakshatra. The first thing is the caste. The caste allotted to this Nakshatra is of a Shudra caste. Shudra caste means a service class, because there are different caste system which has been followed in Hindu astrology system. Like the way Brahmin is an intellectual caste, Kshatriya is all those people who are more inclined towards the power. Same ways the service caste, and the only rational explanation for this is that in older times, just because this Nakshatra has lot to do with the agriculture, with producing something, farming, so all those people of who were not considered as at par with with the Brahmins or with the Kshatriyas, they used to do and get engaged in all those kind of activities. So Shudra is the caste attached to this Nakshatra. When it comes to gender, so this Nakshatra is a completely female gender, has got a female gender because of the two feminine planets, which I am repeatedly saying. When it comes to the direction, so this Nakshatra rules the east direction. When it comes to the body parts and the humor, so body parts, this Nakshatra rules the forehead, the ankle and the shins and the calves of the leg. The humor, it belongs to the kapha, the watery constitution. When it comes to the guna, tattva and the gana, so first thing is guna. So this Nakshatra is a rajasic, it belongs to the rajasic guna, because of too much of the earthly qualities, too much of the inclination towards materialism. So the rajasic is the guna which Rohini Nakshatra belongs to. When it comes to the tattva, so this Nakshatra belongs to the earth element. And the guna, so this Nakshatra belongs to the manushya guna, because of too much of the inclination towards the earthly things, earthly accomplishment. The manushya guna has been attached to this Nakshatra by our ancient sages. When it comes to the auspicious and the inauspicious activities which an individual can think of performing at the time of predominance of this Nakshatra, so first of all, just because this is a very lucky, it's a very blessed Nakshatra, so all kind of initiation related things, activities, and a person can think of opting. Anything related to travels, related to farming, can an individual think of opting. All acts of love, marriage, sexuality are considered as auspicious. If you want to go ahead and buy, you know, jewelry, clothes, buying a vehicle, so all of that can be considered as good. So in a nutshell, majority of the activities, the only activities which are considered as inauspicious at the predominance of this nakshatra are anything related to death, destruction and demolishing. So apart from that, majority of the activities are considered as auspicious in this particular Rohini nakshatra. And you know, one thing which I forgot to mention in the introductory video, that just because of the too much of the feminine quality involved in it, I have in my own research, I have seen even the with the male people, you know, being driven by this nakshatra, who would be more inclined towards adding pink color in their wardrobe, who will be more inclined towards, you know, wearing too much of the perfume. So this is what the energy of this nakshatra is, which is all about beauty, charm, elegance and the strong magnetism. When it comes to the disposition, lunar month and day, so first of all, this nakshatra belongs to the second day of both the waxing and the waning phases of the moon in its every monthly cycle. This nakshatra belongs to the second half of the lunar Kartik month, which falls in the month of the November as per the solar calendar. And when it comes to the disposition, so it's a Dhruva nakshatra, which means which is permanent, which is stable. You know, like the way seasons have a fixed time to come and go, you know, trees bear the fruit at the right time. So all of those can we see from over here. So it is a permanent, it is a Dhruva nakshatra. When it comes to its sexual type and the gotra, its celestial lineage. So sexual type is that, you know, a male serpent, cobra, male serpent, male snake has been attached as a sexual type of this nakshatra, which is very much compatible with the other, you know, female reptile, the snake, which is the Mrikshira nakshatra, which we'll discuss later on. But yeah, this also tells about the inherent sexual qualities of this nakshatra, because snakes are considered as very adept at the sexual acts. And what has been written in our scripture is that the goddess, the feminine goddess assigned to this nakshatra, she was considered as adept, very master in all the 32 principles of the sexual union. That is the only reason why the moon god refused to leave the abode of the Rohini. So this is all what we can see as a sexual type. When it comes to the clan, the lineage of this nakshatra, so this nakshatra has been assigned the Atri, sage Atri, as its gotra, which is all about one who consumes. Now, because you know, the sage Atri has been assigned four nakshatras out of all the 27 nakshatras. Two are the most creative and the constructive ones, two are the most destructive ones. And when it comes to this nakshatra, it has the potential for both the acts. It could take you, elevate you to the spiritual heights where, you know, you want to do something good, where you want the whole world to love you. And the negative side, the flip side of it is that you might run into all the materialism. So this is about the gotra, the celestial lineage assigned to this Rohini nakshatra. When it comes to the profession and the places, so it's very simple. All what you need to do is that you need to first understand the behavior of the nakshatra, which is in consideration, as this nakshatra is all about the farming, agriculture. So all the professions, you know, which requires handling of farms, handling of crops, you know, selling, processing of crops. Now that can be a herbalist, now that can be a botanist. So all of those profession can be associated with this nakshatra, just because chariot, you know, the ox cart is the symbol of this nakshatra. This nakshatra is also associated with all kind of travels. So people engaged in the travel, you know, can be seen as a profession. And all those places where those, you know, the railway station, the bus station, bus stop can be seen as a place governed by this nakshatra. And you know, one more thing which I forgot to mention, like the way I told you, the predominance of this nakshatra can make someone very much interested in the perfumes, the pinkish, the feminine colors. Same ways, you know, the influence of this nakshatra also makes someone inclined towards a luxury vehicle as well. You know, all those people in today's time who are driving the BMWs, the Jaguars, the luxury cars might also be under the influence of this nakshatra. So the profession places we have discussed, all the cosmetic, the beautician, all those, you know, arts, entertainment, industry, the people engaged in those profession can be seen as under the influence of the Rohini nakshatra. Along with that, all those places where the creative works take place can also be seen as a right place being governed and being in sync with this Rohini nakshatra. So this is all what I wanted to say as my take on defining the personality of this Rohini Nakshatra. In the last part, we will try to get into the core of the functioning of this Nakshatra, where we will try to understand that how a planet is going to behave if it will be present in the different padas, different quarters of this Nakshatra, along with some remedial measure. So I hope you guys found my this video informational. For further more updates and notification on astrology, please subscribe my channel and like my Facebook page. Thanks. Shivoh